up? This is Nico, No Hit Videos, another episode. And we're doing something a little different today. We're going to be at the actual Adelphia Studios, and this is our first multi-camera shoot, which means there's a bunch of cameras going around. And I actually also, for a first, I have a female co-host. And I'm going to introduce her as, her name is Lynn Julian, a.k.a. Cookie Cutter Girl. And here she is.
We needed a little estrogen. You know, look at this. We needed a little estrogen, right?
Oh. It's already
started. Am I right?
How you doing, Lynn?
Good.
Or Cutter, what do you want me to call you?
Julian or Cutter is fine, you know, depending on who's in charge at the moment.
So what's Cookie Cutter Girl all about?
Cookie Cutter Girl, I'm so glad you asked, is free women from the mold in which society holds them captive. She's got 30-second commercial spots coming out, and, you know, I don't do her nearly as well as she does. Nobody tells Cutter what to do. And she basically wants to ask the world, are you a cookie-cutter girl, or did you break the mold? Which means, you know, are you letting society tell you how to walk and talk and think and dress, or are you breaking the mold and being your own person? And I'm sure you at No Hit Videos are all about breaking the mold.
No, I follow suit all the time. I do as I'm told by my producer.
I'm starting a leash trend, he says.
So you have a CD and stuff like that out as well?
I do. I have a comic book in the works, Cookie Cutter Girl, by Sonic Comics, Ron and Justine Fontes. Ron is the ex-art director for Marvel Comics right here in Reedfield, Maine. And Justine is the queen of licensed children's books, and she has done thousands. And
it's got a comic strip on the inside.
Right. Basically. This is a teaser for the comic, which will be out at the end of the year. And it's all about female empowerment. Empowerment,
that.
You know? I'm not just yanking your chain. not that I wouldn't like to.
Uh-oh.
But anyway, Cutter is freeing women. She's all about, she takes over when Julian feels that she can't go on anymore. And she just takes over Julian's body and Julian discovers that she has inner strength she never knew about, and she has the ability not only to save herself, but to help other women all across the world do the same exact thing. It's all about discovering your own superhero inside you.
So
I've got mine now.
Cutter takes over Julian's body.
Absolutely. Julian sort of blacks out and Cutter takes over. So if that happens, we're okay.
Well, what if I turned into Cutter? I could take over Julian.
Well, exactly. Now, you know,
I
like pink
too.
Lipstick. No, she'll tell you all about it, you know. She's in charge. Once she's in charge, she's in charge. And on the site, cookiecuttergirl.com, we've got all kinds of Cutter gear. She has a headband with a third eye stone. It helps her read women's minds.
Hold on, we got to go back to that website. What was the website again? We
do a little cookiecuttergirl.com.
It
wow.
does a
scrolling
there.
Now I feel powerful.
So it'll pop right up, and
wow.
folks at home will actually be able to see it, maybe remember it. And on your website,
the power bracelets, and these help her deflect the evil power of the Dominator, who is the villain, the arch-villain of Cookie Cutter Girl.
The Dominator.
The Dominator, just like the pizzas, you know. And that deflects the power and points it right back at them, you know. And so there's the cuffs, and they have guitar pick chokers. We've got.
So you do play the guitar, then you're not just a.
Not just
a pretty face.
Say it. Oh,
not just
thank
a pretty
you,
face.
Thank you. Thank you.
You can actually play and sing and everything.
Yes, I write. I wrote all the songs and co-produced it. They were done at True Sound Audio right here in Vassalboro, and produced at Clarity Cassettes. It's really a Maine-based project.
And we've done a show on Clarity, so that's cool.
Yeah. And we've got patches and stickers and magnets and EPs and, you know, you name it, we got it on the site. Buttons, guitar picks, t-shirts, it's all there.
Cool.
Hats.
Well, hopefully you guys check out the site. We're going to go to a video. We're going to go to Super Soul Challenger that we did for a no-hit video shoot at the Asylum. So check them out.
Hey, no time right now to breathe.
We're back. That was Super Soul Challenger at the Asylum. Julian's going to tell us what band's coming up next at the Asylum.
Disaster Complex from when they assaulted the Asylum.
Let's check them out. Not just janking your chain.
About that, I had some technical difficulties. This next song is called Indiscriminate Hate.
Mistake. I don't know how it took place, but still it remains. And how the hell did I get into all of this? As I'm looking back at my past, blighted by the emptiness that fills me up inside and manifests. Then I don't know how I got into all of this. And I just wanted to fade and pass all of these memories. Just will not let me be. You've agitated the surface. You don't know how to work this. You are all just.
Oh.
Right now!
We're back. Oh, we're back. Okay, we're
Sorry.
Back. Just,
pardon me.
Little, yeah, let's see. Anyhow, I'm all flustered. I don't know where we were at.
Cut.
That was Disaster Complex at the Asylum. And you guys may notice I wear this Vic Firth shirt. Also, Vic Firth drumsticks. We did a show on them as well. Nico, GUT Music Online. I am now endorsed by Vic Firth. And
now how sweet is that?
Endorsing them. So buy Vic Firth drumsticks. Wow. Or you could even go to our website and buy my drumsticks that say Nico right on them, the logo and stuff like that. Zoom in. Anyhow, a month or so ago, we were down at the Asylum. We ran across Chuck from B-Movie Extras and from It Magazine. He's the, I guess, the owner or producer of It Magazine, local magazine that supports all your local bands. It's free, so pick it up. It's usually at clubs in the local Portland area. And we're going to go to that interview. We talk about Chuck, and he probably talks about everything else. So go right to the interview. Hey, what's happening? Nico down here. I'm out front of the Asylum, and I'm standing with Chuck Yoho. And he's, number one, he plays in B-Movie Extras, but he also is the founder of, I believe, It Magazine. It Magazine is all about the locals and stuff. Chuck, tell us a little bit about it.
Well, it's just a magazine me and a bunch of my musician friends started to promote all the great bands here in Maine, you know? Yep. You know, I mean, Grand Unified Theory being one of them, of course.
Yeah, that's cool. And he also has been plugging right along, usually has the times and the days that No Hit Videos is on there. And write-ups and reviews and stuff, correct?
Yeah. Yep. Yeah, we have, you know, live reviews, CD reviews. There's a few, like, three or four different features every month. We try to cover, you know, like, all the bases. We have acoustic acts, you know, heavy acts, of course, which is, you know, where our hearts lie, you know.
I like Lawrence Welk.
You know, we have a hip-hop column. We have... you know, we try to cover everything, you know, but we're definitely, if you have an idea and you want to be part of this magazine, just email us at itrockrag.com.
Itrockrag.com.
Was I going to scroll?
Oh, yeah. Wow,
high tech, you guys. Awesome. You know, we'll definitely listen to your ideas. Maybe you can help out, you know. It's definitely a community thing. We want everyone to be involved. It's not just about a certain amount of bands. We want to cover from the smallest band, high school band, to, you know, the biggest band in Maine, so
which is
Grand Unified Theory.
There's Dead Season and Lost and B-Movie Extras. Yeah. I'm sure you've heard of them.
Yeah, they're pretty good too.
They've been around. tell me now, how about how's that funding? I mean, you're looking for people that want to sponsor and advertise and stuff like that?
Actually, yeah. I mean, some of the clubs around Portland have been good enough to, you know, we have the Big Easy, we have the Asylum, you know, and they're throwing in their hard-earned dollars to help keep this afloat. But, you know, a lot of money comes out of my pocket, my partner's pocket every month. You know, right now we're not turning a profit. I mean, I'm going to be honest with you. But we're doing it because we love this music scene and we think there's a lot of great, you know, talent here, and we just want to get it out to everybody. But, you know, we can use any amount of help that anyone can give. You know, if you have a gig and you want to, you know, promote it, this is a good place to do it. So, you know, and we're cheap, you know, we're not charging an arm and a leg. So
he's cheap, all right. I don't know, I took him out last night.
Yeah.
No, but also it is all about the local scene, and just like No Hit Videos, I mean, we don't make anything off this. It cost me money to have you guys out there, but yeah, it's worth, you know, promoting the local scene and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And I appreciate
yeah, no,
you know,
yeah,
The magazine, the TV show. We've got the local radio stations that do the local homegrown and spin out and homemade jam.
Someday when we, you know, we're going to conglomerate all this and we're going to be like a media mogul. You know, we'll have No Hit Videos, It Magazine. You know, we got Chase over there at TOS. And we'll put them all together and we'll just take over this whole scene.
Yeah.
You heard it here on No Hit Videos. We'll be right back.
falling down.
Hey, we're back. And those of you just tuning in, I'm sitting in with Julian, or Lynn Julian, a.k.a. Cookie Cutter Girl. I'm calling her Cutter now. And she's going to discuss a little bit more of another thing that she has. Aside from the music stuff, she also makes velvet chokers. Tell us about
that.
I do.
I have a website, aptly named velvetchokers.com.
Makes sense.
We do rhinestone and velvet jewelry. There's velvet chokers, satin chokers. We range from cameos. Oohs and ahs, yes. Where's the in-studio audience for the oohs and ahs?
Ah.
This is the choker from the Genie X from the Terminal Diner comic book, and this is the official Genie X choker, and this gives her all her secret power. And these are belly chains. These are the most popular items that we do, the rhinestone belly chains, and you know, you would look wonderful in one of these.
I would, in which one?
They go very well with the whole chain thing, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that would fit me.
Well, you know, there's an extension chain. See, my chain's not as big as yours.
Well, I've known to be, I won't say.
And this is the most popular velvet choker now. This is the Vampira special.
Vampira.
And we make them up to like 30, 40 inches long. You can make them any length so that they hang way down like this or up around the neck, and it's the...
Oh, that does look a vampire type thing.
Oh, yes. This is the key to the hunger.
So what's the website again for that?
Velvetchokers.com.
Velvetchokers.com.
I feel so powerful when we get to do that. And everything is handmade by me personally and to your satisfaction.
So you can just check it out. Yes. And with that type of vampire type thing, we're going to go to By Blood Alone. Have you heard of them?
Yes!
She's a female singer, and that's kind of vampire-esque type stuff. So check it out. By Blood Alone at the Asylum. No hit video shoot. Not just janking your chain. Many of you guys might have seen the show that we did. It was fairly recent. I had the chance to interview Brian from American Head Charge, Brian and Justin. Well, previously after that show, just shortly after that show aired, Brian from American Head Charge was found passed away in his bus. So I wanted to give a shout out to everybody out there, fans of American Head Charge. He was a great guy, and I had a blast, you know, hanging out with him that night. And we're going to play their video again, Loyalty, American Head Charge, going into the unlocal section. Take it away.
When I My name is Tom O from the Mountain Morning Show on 105 TOS. You know me, I'm on the radio. But when music's not enough and I need some sort of visual stimulation, I know where to go, and so do you. It's No Hit Videos.
Set me up to your desire.
That was hushed at the asylum after they actually had the lights bright enough so we could see them. Anyhow, that about wraps it up for this episode, and we're going to end it with GUT. First, we're going to say goodbye to Cutter, the cookie cutter girl. And we're going to end the video with... Thanks, by the way.
Thanks for having me.
We're going to go to a GUT video.
Girl power!
Goodbye!
Break the mold!
Now,
yeah. Okay, now it's time for our own video.
Okay.
It's hard to breathe.